The morning sun shines on the gleaming hide of a muscular ranch horse. The aroma of bacon and coffee drifts from the wood cook stove at a cow camp. Silver spurs jingle as the men and women of the West get set for another day in the saddle. From the heart of Canada's finest ranching country, this is the Spirit of the West with rancher and horse trainer Hugh McLennan and his collection of music, poetry, and conversations with the folks who live and work with horses and cattle in the Spirit of the West.
The word cowboy has different meanings, it seems, for some folks who have never stepped outside the glass and concrete jungles of the big cities. I really get annoyed when I hear the term used in a derogatory manner from a politician or a journalist that has no idea what it really means. And that's the focus of Baxter Black's commentary today.
His critics cursed him as a cowboy, and he took it as a compliment. They never knew the difference.
Yes, Baxter talks at length about the cowboy way. And on the Rangeland News, a lot of interesting items, including this one.
A food product grown from the cells of cattle. Is it beef? Is it even meat? Is it safe?
In the cowboy poetry spotlight, top hand Randy Reiman has one of the classics.
Not a horse is feeling snorty. Not one horse is acting sporty. In the spring, the brutes was full of buck and ball. But now they're gentle as they're dragging to the home ranch with the wagon. For they finished shipping cattle in the fall.
And Sam Simon is back this week to share more of his amazing journey from India to Kuwait and finally to the rangelands of the West.
Family has a hard time trying to understand what this is all about. They're like, so you do what? I said, well, I ride horses and chase cows. Is that like what we see on TV? I'm like, kinda. Minus the guns.
On the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, if you've ever watched a group of good cowboys, men or women, working cattle, look closely at the position of their horse's head, and I'll look at the difference between how you can tell the top hands from the wannabes. Marty Robbins has this week's classic song of the West, and a guy who is coming to the 2019 Kamloops Cowboy Festival, Mike Fleming, sets the mood.
On the back roads of Utah near the San Rafael, an old rough stock rider strides to the corral. His body all battered from battles he's fought, all whalebone and rawhide and eyes like a hawk. He takes a deep seat on a Mustang that waits like a time bomb just ticking away. Flash of the spur and the mad dance of hooves, and a Bronkbuster starts a new day. At the rodeo nobody knows, no crowds here allowed, no trophies of gold. Every day there's a Wild West show at the rodeo nobody knows.
A young man on horseback in the West Texas brush, searching for strays left behind in the bush. He senses a movement below in the draw. His cow pony tenses and waits for the call. Then out with a mad dash and down the ravine, the young maverick races away. And right there behind him and building a loop, the hand closes in on his prey. At the rodeo nobody knows, no crowds here allowed, no trophies of gold. Every day there's a Wild West show at the rodeo. No.
What they were destined to do. At the rodeo, nobody
I'm so glad to see that that guy, Michael Fleming, will be back at the Kamloops Cowboy Festival coming up in March, and it's probably not too soon to start thinking about maybe a season's or weekend's pass as a stocking stuffer. That is one powerful song. Well, I've already had a ton of comments on last week's program with Sam Simon, and you heard then how an East Indian kid who grew up in Kuwait followed his dream of being a working cowboy, and today it's part two of Sam's story.
Well, that's a wonderful story, Sam. Yeah. It really is. Yeah. And I see the passion in your eyes when you're working with these guys and you're accepted as one of their peers now. I mean, that's got to mean so much.
Oh,
you know,
it does.
You kind of admired them from a distance for years, and now you're one of them.
Yeah. No, and that's like when I kind of got around all these guys through Pioneer Ranch camps out in Sundry, and I've heard of Bryn Thiessen and Gordy Cunningham, and these guys sounded larger than life.
Yeah.
And then, you know, it just took the courage to go up to them and say, hey, I don't know much. I'd like to learn. Would you be willing to, if you let me tag along?
Yeah.
And I won't promise if I won't get in the way. And if I do, yell at me.
Well,
so I've had lots of that.
Well, yeah, if you're going to join a cowboy crew, I mean, getting yelled at is all a big part of it.
It's a learning experience, and you kind of, you know, and I took that. And, you know, it's an education, so you kind of have to. If somebody's yelling at you, and I mean, it does get old after a while. You're like, well, I've learned it. Let me try.
Yeah.
Give me a try.
Yeah.
And then if I mess up, sure, after the drive when cattle are where we needed to get them, and I'll come back and say, I'm sorry if I was in there. They're like, no, we just needed you to hear. And you know, and then it takes a while to kind of, and then you know guys and you get to know how they work. And then as years progress, you kind of figure out, okay, I need to be here. And then, I mean, we always plan at the ranch, you know, we're going to do this. We're going to move cows from here. We'll get. And as soon as you go through the gate and you hit the first cow or the first pair, the plan changed. Like the plan you talked about at the ranch house is not the plan that's going to unfold. And cows are going every which way. And it's pretty much okay.
Adjust on the fly and do what you got to do.
Yeah. You know, it's kind of the plan's as good as you hit the first cow and then. Then it changes, and then everybody, and then that's so much I'm working on a crew is, you know, to kind of watch and see how the guys are responding to what the cattle are doing and where guys are positioning themselves.
I've often said handling cattle from horseback is more than a science. It can be an art form. And we'll talk more about that with Sam Simon and a song that really resonates with anyone who's topped a ridge on a frosty morning, sat on a good horse, and looked at a valley full of cattle ready to be gathered. When the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. This is the time of year when a lot of gathering, sorting, and shipping is going on. Calves are being weaned, dry cows cut out, bulls sorted off, and it's when we try to have our best equine partners ready for the job. And yeah, there's a lot of noise, cows and calves bawling, and any verbal instructions are totally lost to the wind. The riders just have to read the herd and read the situation and the other riders and make it all work. And that's one of the things that we're talking about today with Sam Simon.
Kind of read the situation. It's not easy.
No, you know, it's almost an art form.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody that is uninitiated and hasn't been involved might think it's either total chaos or who knows what.
Yeah.
But you watch these savvy guys and you learn to think like they do and you begin to understand cattle behavior, cow psychology, and those cows will teach you so much about what they're thinking right now.
Yeah.
And so often, I say, give them time to think.
Yeah.
You know, let them think
and
set it up. And then when you work by yourself with fairly good-sized bunches, you really get that.
Yeah. You know. No, and that was something I learned with Gordy Cunningham and guys like Jim Bauer out of the Anchor JB Ranch there. Jim kind of actually started me on, gave me my first experiences with working with cattle, and that was on foot in a corral, and, you know, Sam walked to their rib, and they'll walk forward, or, you know, and then at that point, if somebody told me flight zones and balance points, I would have been like, I have no idea what you're talking about. But then going to clinics and going, like, watching Martin and what those videos, like, I kind of wanted to learn, and I was like, well, how do I, I'm not saying Martin Black's the be-all and end-all of everything. I mean, there's stuff that you pick up from all these other clinicians. Them guys have done it, so there's truth and there's sense to what they're saying.
Well, we'll get back to Sam shortly, but as he says, there are a lot of good hands around, and, you know, I have certainly observed there are a lot of good young ranching couples around today. And just like the folks who are in the saddle doing the job, there are some terrific young singers and songwriters who put the passion into their music about cowboy life. Folks like Ryan Fritz and Matt Robertson and Kevin Davis, just a few that come to mind. And, of course, Bren Hill. And boy, how often have so many of us said, I wish I was 20 and cowboy again.
Somewhere tonight on Big D Double L, you're watching the sun going down. And there's a chill coming on and the fire's burning well as you look out across hallowed ground. And there's a coyote dancing along Mackie Draw. There's a golden hawk perched on the wire. And there's a bedroll waiting for your head to fall as you stare deep into the campfire. And I've been camped where you are, and I've wished upon the same star, and I would give every last penny I'll spend if I could be 20 and cowboy again. On an old Tex-Tan saddle with no bucking rolls and a hand-me-down shank snaffle bit and a rawhide Rietta too long to hold, and a pair of old chinks that don't fit. And 17 miles from the highway across to the head of the summertime range, and there's no one but you and the crew and the boss, and there's nowhere to hide if it rains. And I've been camped where you are, and I've wished upon the same stars, and I would give every last penny I'll spend if I could be 20 and cowboy again. I've been camped where you are, and I've wished upon the same stars, and I would give every last penny I'll spend if I could be 20 and cowboy again.
Well, Sam Simon started his first colt at a Martin Black clinic, and he learned a lot. And the high-profile trainers like Martin and Buck and Doug and Jonathan and so many others have a wealth of knowledge to share, for sure.
There's truth and there's sense to what they're saying.
Yeah, and there are some, you know, it's a world that's not recognized by the general public, or they don't even know it exists.
Yeah.
But there are absolute consummate top hands everywhere.
Yeah.
Young guys, old season hands, and they have developed the science and the art of cowboy. To an amazing degree.
Oh no, it's not something you can pick up a book and learn to any
Absolutely
to any
not.
Degree. No, you kind of have to.
You got to make your mistakes.
You got to make the mistakes
and clean
and let the
completely
cow
by a bunch
you.
Of cows.
Oh yeah, and then
lose them. And did you get them in there? No, I lost them.
Well, I got them up to the gate, and then everything turned and came right over
We've
me. And then
that before,
you know, and then working dogs, that's a whole different...
You work with dogs, too. I imagine with your background in Dobermans, that would kind of...
I've got two Border Collies, and, you know, all my horses kind of... I mean, I've gotten my string pretty much from Brins, and the dog, one of the dogs comes from there, and another one comes from some Bev and Norm Summer up in Saskatchewan. They trial dogs, and even so you'd go and work with guys and work them on sheep and kind of learn the idea, yeah. But it's times when you go out by yourself and the dog, and you're like, I got to get all this through the gate. And yeah. The whole idea of slow things down is something that you kind of have, give him daylight, give him time
exactly.
to think. Let him look at the gate.
Give him time to think.
And then lie the dog down or get after the dog if she's getting, like, but just, you know, cattle, good, if somebody said quiet hands make quiet cattle.
Yeah.
And fast hands are, you know, make fast cattle. And there's quite a bit of truth to it. And, but no, I've been fortunate to be around some good hands and here in Canada too, and to learn from some of the guys that come up from the States. And it's a try. It's a lot of try.
Yeah.
It does come down to it. You have to have some try to kind of want to
It. And, gosh, I mean, it's easy to say, well, you know, I don't think I can do this right now. I'm going to.
And from my background and from my culture, this is foreign.
Is that right?
It's not like, I mean, I'm an East Indian kid, and in India, this is, they're like, because family has a hard time trying to understand what this is all about.
Wow.
They're like, so you do what? I said, well, I ride horses and chase cows. Is that like what we see on TV? I'm like, kind of, minus the guns, you know?
most of the time, and the stagecoach and the...
Because their exposure to it is so limited.
Yeah.
And for me, growing up, it was always an interest. It's not that our family had livestock. And like, I grew up in the Middle East, in the city, in Kuwait, and in an apartment, you know.
We'll continue the discussion with Sam Simon in a little while. Baxter Black has a meaningful commentary on the cowboy way, a good song from Butch Falk, and then the rangeland news when the spirit of the West continues right after this.
Howdy, friends. This is Baxter Black on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan, and I'll be right back with a little peek at the cowboy way. Well, friends, thanks for listening. It'll be no surprise that I've published a beautiful new hardback book called A Commotion in Rhyme. It fits in the bunkhouse, the outhouse, the bookstore, the library, or the cookbook. Unfortunately, it won't fit in a cupcake. Buy two, get one free. A commotion? Oh. Call 800-654-2550 or baxterblack.com. Come to think of it, it might fit in a Caesar salad. It's been a long time since Ronald Reagan was in office. He was the closest thing we'd had to a president since Teddy Roosevelt, who knew the cowboy way. Reagan made reporters nervous. They called him a cowboy. They were used to the typical cover-your-butt behavior they'd come to expect from politicians and bureaucrats. So when he held the slothers' feet to the fire, and when he stood up for the common good, his critics cursed him as a cowboy, and he took it as a compliment. They never knew the difference. Some people talk about the cowboy way like it was a joke or a punchline. But let me tell you, friends, it's a real thing. And you can still see lots of cowboys on Capitol Hill, still doing the work, making the decisions, respected, taking care of us all, Americans.
Have you noticed lately how the world is changing? That our values are adrift upon the sea? But let me say, one man can make a difference, and I'll put it to you plain as I can be. Can I count on you to keep it, cowboy, when the bad guys have your back against the wall? When they try and buy your soul with things that glitter? Can you shed the great temptation after all? Can you sort a real cowboy from a ringer who talks the talk but can't hold up his end? But instead of pointing out he ain't worth shooting, you teach him how and keep him as a friend. For you are your brother's keeper, it is written, and duty bound you are to do your part. Will you stand up for what's right when guns are blazing and the weak need pansies, all are losing heart? See, humans need a solid post to tie to when the truth and what they want to hear gets blurred, when they can't trust all those folks they put in office. They need to know one man who keeps his word. One whose presence in their life is a reminder that character still matters on its own.
All I'm asking you to do is keep it, cowboy.
Put
so the world around you has a cornerstone. Baxter Black
on Spirit of the West with Hugh McLennan.
Thanks for listening.
Farm Fair International, one of Canada's top agricultural shows, returns this November 7th to 11th. Guests from around the world will gather in the Edmonton region to show and sell top quality livestock, make important connections, share knowledge, and build our industry. While you're there, enjoy shopping in Ram Country Marketplace or take in the Heritage Ranch Rodeo. It's a big deal to buy, sell, and connect. Make sure you're there. Plan your visit at farmfairinternational.com. Well, just ahead of the rangeland news, here's a combination that goes together like a good horse and a top hand. Texas rancher Gary Prescott, by the way, Gary's wife Jean Prescott, will be coming to the Kamloops Cowboy Festival next March, but Gary Prescott wrote this and BC rancher Butch Falk sings it. It's called Strike a Lope.
As the cattle all bed down for the evening, that old sun disappears behind the hill. An eagle cries out high above me, and I turn up my collar to the evening chill. I've been riding the pastures for a week now, 7 long days that I've been gone. This cowboy's mind keeps on stampeding to the woman he loves waiting there at home. So strike a lope and let's hit the trail, old partner. We'll fly like the wind while there's still light. Across the miles that we're apart to the one that owns my heart. We gotta make it home by tonight. Grass is stirrup deep across the meadow, and the cattle wintered fine again this year. This springtime riding lifts a cowboy's spirit. The master's touch is everywhere out here. The flowers on the hillside are blooming. Winter's cold is just a memory. It's got this cowboy dreaming of a sweetheart and one last kiss beneath the live oak tree. So strike a lope and let's hit the trail, old partner. We'll fly like the wind while there's still light. Across the miles that we're apart to the one that owns my heart. We gotta make it home by tonight. Cowboy moon is hanging over the mountain. Somewhere in the distance, a coyote bays. His hoofbeats echo softly down the canyon. The twinkling stars all come out to play. It's been too long since I've seen my darling. Miss her more every time I'm gone. But the distance between our hearts is getting closer, and it won't be long until we make it home. So strike a lope and let's hit the trail, old partner. We'll fly like the wind while there's still light. Across the miles that we're apart to the one that owns my heart. Gotta make it home by tonight. Looks like we're gonna make it home tonight.
Now
the news of the rangeland, a roundup of news and coming events from around the West.
At the top of page one, it says things are changing pretty fast in this era of high tech and scientific research, and now beef is being grown in a lab, and it may not be that long before it's available, and that opens up a whole bunch of questions, and Gary Crawford has raised a few.
A food product grown from the cells of cattle. Is it beef? Is it even meat? Is it safe? What agency should decide those issues? The Ag Department that regulates and inspects livestock products, or FDA that handles other processed foods? The other day, Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue gave an audience his take on it.
We believe that FDA has some equity at the beginning of this process in the laboratory and making sure there are safe products that could be commercialized. When they become to the commercial stage, we think that's USDA's responsibility to regulate and to inspect those products, and that's what we will work toward.
That would cut industry confusion in this complex matter, and Purdue said,
we can go a long way between FDA and USDA in resolving how we move forward quickly.
Some companies say they're going to be ready to market cultured meat in a year or two, so Purdue says moving quickly is vital.
We don't want this new technology to feel like they've got to go offshore outside of the United States to get a fair regulatory protocol.
USDA and FDA will hold a two-day joint meeting on this whole issue later this month. Gary Crawford for the U.S. Department of Agriculture, Washington.
American corn is flowing into southern Alberta at a brisk rate because of a shortfall in domestic feed grains. Corn is currently cheaper than the traditional barley ration that most Alberta feedlots use, and the U.S. is anticipating a 250-million-tonne corn harvest this year, and it sure doesn't take that much to supply the Canadian market. This fall's cold, wet harvest could release more feed wheat and barley. Tough, damp grain will be forced into the feed market as quickly as possible. A grizzly bear killed a calf on a ranch in central Montana earlier this week, and there seems to be more evidence that bears are moving further out of their traditional territory. Montana Fish, Wildlife, and Parks announced that a calf was killed by a grizzly after an investigation was conducted by the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Wildlife Services, and they confirmed the death was depredation by a bear. The calf was killed on a ranch near Two Dot, an area of the state where grizzlies are not common. Wildlife officials believe that the bears are expanding their territory from the Northern Continental Divide ecosystem and the Greater Yellowstone ecosystem, where they are established grizzly populations. Grizzly bears are still listed as threatened under the Endangered Species Act, and for a while they were temporarily delisted last year. But protection for grizzly bears was reinstated by a federal judge in September, halting what would have been the first grizzly hunts in the lower 48 since 1991. And a case of bovine tuberculosis has been confirmed in a cow herd in Michigan. A large beef cattle herd in Alcona County was confirmed to have bovine TB by the Michigan Department of Agriculture and Rural Development on October the 9th. The herd was identified through routine surveillance and testing. Michigan has had a number of bovine TB cases, and much of it is due to wild white-tailed deer carrying the disease through the state's modified accredited zone. Well, on October the 29th at the BC Livestock Co-op Yards in Okanagan Falls, there's a special calf and regular sale. And then October 30th, a special Angus Influence calf sale and regular sale at the Kamloops Yards. And on October 31st, a calf sale at the Williams Lake Yards, and the regular sale November 1st, and a pre-sort sale at the Vanderhoof Yards on November 2nd. You can get all the information at bclivestock.bc.ca. Meanwhile, at the Innisfail Auction Market, pre-sort sales with calves being weighed starting at 8 a.m. on Sundays, and you're asked to have your calves in before 5 p.m. on Friday, if possible, and regular sales every Wednesday at 9 o'clock with butcher cows and bulls, feeders and yearlings to follow. And you can get all the information and book your cattle at 1-800-710-3166 or see InnisfailAuctionMarket.com. And I guess that's it. We're down to the final item. And this takes me back a while. A few years ago when I was still playing hockey with a bunch of old guys, and we had a pretty high-profile team with our own sweaters and numbers and everything. And somebody asked, why didn't your hockey team have a website? And the answer? Well, they just couldn't string three W's together.
And that's the truth, and that's the Rangeland News. Coming up on the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File, a look at how you can tell the experienced top hands from the wannabes when they're working cattle. And we'll have more from Sam Simon when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. Autumn is a great time to be a cowboy. That's when the horses are seasoned and solid after a long summer's work, and now the best kind of stuff is happening. Weaning, sorting, and shipping, and in our part of the West, it's pretty much all done on horseback. And I've seen it for years. The pros with their best horses working quietly with no wasted motion, a minimum of energy expended, and the cattle respond in the same way, and the horses have their heads down and the minds on the job. I'll talk about some of the subtle things the riders are doing to help their horses be at their best on the Urban Saddles and Western Wear Horse Training File coming right up. Now, after the calves and culls are shipped and the snow begins to cover the rangeland, that's when we head up to the hills looking for the tracks of the stragglers that are still missing. And Ryan Fritz has done a lot of that.
The first snow has fallen sweet like icing. I'd like to eat. Oh, I can't wait to leave this shack and go lay a set of tracks. There's cattle that I need to find. I've really just been killing time, waiting for the snow to tell me where to go. Now it's time to ride from the mountain down through the pine, and how you better wait as my winter riding begins. The valley cloud is laying low like all the winters that I know out here on the western side. That rocky grade divide, but way up high, the sun will shine. It's colder, but I don't mind. Hey, there's a track on that lost steer. What's he doing way up here? Now it's time to ride from the mountains down through the pine. And how you better wait as my winter riding begins. And wait, the tracks don't seem to lead nowhere. I wish that steer was standing there. A fire sure would feel good now and warm me up. But there's a cow, oh, steaming horse back from the chase, is gonna warm me anyways. Now it's time to ride from the mountains down through the pines. So how you better wind as my winter riding begins. How you better wind as my winter riding begins.
So what are you doing from August 29th to September 13th, 2019?
Well, Billy and I will be hosting our 18th annual Spirit of the West cruise, and here's where we'll be going. We'll fly to Dublin, Ireland. We'll be visiting an Irish thoroughbred breeding farm. We'll be hosted by the Irish Cattle Breeding Federation, and then we'll sail to some historic and beautiful places, including Cork, Belfast, then Glasgow and Inverness, Scotland. And we might even get pictures of Nessie the Loch Ness Monster. And we'll have stops in Paris and London. Now, this is something we've always wanted to do, and we'd love to have you join us. Get all the information at us, 1-800-530-0131. And check our Spirit of the West cruise page at hugh-mclennan.com and our cruise Facebook page.
Now it's time for the Horse Training File, brought to you by Irvine Tack and Western Wear, Canada's largest Western store.
Well, it's not frozen flagpole kind of cold just yet, but it's getting chilly out there. Good to know Irvine Tack and Western Wear has over 70,000 square feet of everything you need this fall. Boots, jeans, shirts, hoodies, jackets, and hey, it's always fun shopping Irvine's. You should see the new fall decor and collectibles, and well, the longer I go on, the less time you have to shop, so I'd best be on my way. To Irvine's, of course, off exit 305 on Highway 2 by Crossfield, open 7 days a week.
Canada's largest Western store.
It's actually a question of angles. If you've ever watched a group of top hands working cattle in close quarters, like what you'd see at a good ranch rodeo, if you watch closely, the horses work pretty much on a loose rein, fully collected with their heads level. If you watch a group of inexperienced riders trying to do the same thing, you'll often find the horse is out of position, their heads are up in the air and counterbending instead of working on their hocks with their head where they should be so they can watch the cattle. Now that all starts with a critical angle. That's the angle between the point where the reins attach to the shanks of a curb bit or the rings of a snaffle and the rider's hands. If the angle is wrong, the horse will respond to rein pressure by elevating his head. And that means the angle is wrong because the rider's hands are too high. If the angle is right, the response to rein pressure will be a soft yield. The horse will flex at the pole, relax his jaw, and give properly to the bit. Now, to find the angle, all you need to do is get your hands to the place where you get the proper response. When the angle is right, the horse will be able to keep watching the cow, lead into a turn by first looking and then moving his head, neck, and shoulders in the direction of the turn. If it's a left turn, it starts with the left front foot. In the early stages, you'll need to help start the turn with the direct rein, and as the horse progresses, he should respond more and more to the indirect or neck rein, and after enough time and training, he'll respond properly with the collection with just leg and neck rein pressure, and that's the point where you might be ready to introduce him to a bit with shanks. And eventually, you'll have a horse that, what we call, up in the bridle. And that's the Horse Training File. For Irvine Saddles and Western Wear, something else that our horses really enjoy is that daily feeding of Hoffman's Horse Ration. They all get it now, and you can find out more at hoffmanshorseration.com. Are you looking to improve production and increase profitability in your beef operation? Come to Beef Tech, November 8th and 9th. This interactive beef industry learning event will give you the opportunity to explore and experience emerging technologies and innovative management practices. Keynote presentations include Marty Seymour, Farm Credit Canada, the Peterson Farm Brothers, and Jim Bottomley. Don't miss this great opportunity to learn from leading industry experts and increase your profitability. Register at northlands.com/beeftech. When Sam Simon was growing up in Kuwait after moving from his native India, he was fascinated by some of the television programs that showed him a little bit of the North American West.
You know, documentaries like National Geographic and stuff like that. One of the guys, Ken McKenzie, he works dogs out of Drayton Valley. Ken was featured on Dogs with Jobs on National Geographic, and I saw this show in India. And I saw that, and I was like, I forget where they were, but it was Alberta, and I knew there was horses and cows in Alberta. And then I was like, I don't know, somehow that I kind of got in, after I got my dog, I kind of got involved in the trialing side or kind of just go and see. finally met Ken McKenzie and said, you know, wow, I saw you on TV in India. And he's like, what? So I was like, yeah, no, it's the truth. So
you got your degree in engineering.
Yeah, and an undergrad and a master's.
How many languages do you speak? And I'm guessing it would be more than...
Two or three.
Yeah.
Yeah. English was my first language.
It was.
Yeah, because we grew up in... See, I didn't grow up in India, so...
Right.
I grew up in the Middle East. I grew up in Kuwait, and all of us kids that grew up there, English was always our main mode of communication. So, I mean, for me, I think, process, dream in English. So a lot of guys from India and elsewhere will kind of process in their... I mean, this is my interpretation of it, is that they process and think in their local mother tongue. Mm-hmm. And then they try to translate it to English, which probably explains why a lot of sentences don't quite make sense, or it's grammatically wrong, or, you know, so that's kind of part of it.
Yeah. But, oh, my God. Well, Sam, it's just been so great to meet you and watch you in action. And, boy, I hope our trails cross. Maybe we could get horseback somewhere before I get too old.
No, you bet. You bet. No, I appreciate it. And, no, thanks for coming out and being here and helping us.
This is a tough one to judge, I'll tell you.
Yeah.
It's really, really tough. You know, it's great horses and good job.
Yeah, and guys push each other every year and just with what we do. You know, you always kind of, this year they did this, and I guess I get up the game next year and try a little harder and, you know, work a little at it kind of thing.
So what's on your agenda as soon as you get going this week?
Well, it's back to the ranch and you know, we're getting close to fall gather and kind of start that work and get into that.
Start
and
weaning
soon.
They're getting ready for weaning.
Yeah, kind of their cows are on grass. Yeah, they're on grass now, and we'll slowly start bringing them home.
Calling some cows maybe.
Stuff has gone on the list from calving all through now, and we'll kind of find them out in the fall and get ready to wean and ship, and then winter comes and feeding. So
that's Well, again, Sam, thanks for doing this, and like I say, hope we can get together again for too long.
Thanks,
Hugh. Coming up, this week's classic Song of the West from Marty Robbins, and then Randy Reiman in the Cowboy Poetry Spotlight when the Spirit of the West continues right after this. Welcome back to the Spirit of the West. For this week's classic Song of the West, we're going back to a collection from Marty Robbins' Real Good Ones, and I can remember the legendary DJ Curly Gerlach playing some of Marty's earliest songs, and he called him the boy with a teardrop in his voice. This one is from Marty's All-American Cowboy LP, and I thought it would be kind of neat if you could hear the voice of Marty Robbins explaining how he wrote this song.
You know, I have some relatives out in Arizona, old cowboys. Still cowboying for a living, in fact, and they're up in their 70s. Been cowboys all their lives. I guess that's about the only thing they could do. But I want to dedicate this song to them. I wrote this especially for them. It's one called Lonely Old Bunkhouse.
Is alone.
You know, I don't think there are very many of today's working cowboys who have not heard of the poetry of Bruce Kiskaden. You know, there's just something about his rhyme and his meter and his first-hand knowledge of the life that makes his poems so meaningful. Randy Reiman is considered an expert at ranch roping, colt starting, cattle handling, and rawhide breeding, and he's also a great reciter of cowboy poetry, and I love the way he brings this Bruce Kiskaden classic to life.
You know, probably one of the most popular poems to be recited at the gatherings over the last dozen years or so is a poem written by Bruce Kiskaden. It's certainly one of Bruce's best poems, and it's one of my favorites. It's actually one of the first poems I committed to memory. It's called When You Finished Shipping Cattle in the Fall. Well, you're not exactly blue, but you don't feel like you do in the winter, nor on long, hot summer days. Still, your feelings and the weather seem to sort of go together, and you're quiet in that dreamy autumn haze. When that last big steer is goaded up the chute and safely loaded, and the summer crew has ceased to hit the ball, and the feller starts to drag him to the home ranch with the wagon, for he's finished shipping cattle in the fall. Well, there's just two men left a standing on this job for winter's branding, and your partner, he's a loafing at your side. He's got a brand new saddle creaking. Neither one of you is speaking, and you feel it's gonna be a silent ride. But you savvy one another. See, you know him like a brother. Oh, he's friendly. He's just quiet, that is all. And he's thinking as he's dragging to the home ranch with the wagon, for he's finished shipping cattle in the fall. And the saddle horse is stringing in an easy walk, a swinging in behind the old chuck wagon, moving slow. Now they're weary, gaunt, and jaded from the mud and brush they've waded, and they settled down to business long ago. Not a horse is feeling snorty, not one horse is acting sporty. In the spring the brutes was full of buck and ball, but now they're gentle as they're dragging to the home ranch with the wagon, for they finished shipping cattle in the fall. And the cook leads the retreat. He's up there on his wagon seat. He's got his hat pulled away down on his head. He used to make that old team hustle. Now he hardly moves a muscle, and a feller might imagine he was dead. Except his old cob pipes a-smoking as he lets that team go poking, hitting every hump and holler in the road. No, the cookie ain't been drinking. He's just sitting up there thinking about the people and the places that he knowed. Well, you can see the dust a-trailing, two little clouds a-sailing, like a big mirage with lakes and timbers tall. Well, it's lonesome when you're dragging to the home ranch with the wagon and you finish shipping cattle in the fall. Well, you make your camp that night, and though the fire's burning bright, it seems nobody really has a lot to say. In the spring, you sung and hollered. Now you get your supper swallowed and you crawl into your blankets right away. You see the stars a-shining up there in that soft blue lining. You sniff the frosty night air, clear and cool. You hear your night horse shifting and your memory goes to drifting to that little village where you went to school. With its narrow gravel streets and the kids you used to meet and the commons where you used to play baseball. But now you're far away and dragging to the home ranch with the wagon, for you finished shipping cattle in the fall. And your schoolboy's sweetheart, too, with her eyes of honest blue, best performer in the hometown talent show. Well, you was nothing but a kid, and yet you loved her. Yeah, you did. Now that's been nearly 30 years ago. Well, your memory starts to roam from old Mexico to Nome, from the Rio Grande up to the Powder River, and you think of things you'd done, and some of them was lots of fun. But there are other things that make you shiver. Like that boy, his name was Reed, he got killed in a stampede, it was way up north. You helped to dig his grave. And your old friend Jim, the boss, he got tangled with his hoss and the fellas couldn't reach in time to save. And you was there when Ed got his'n, boy that killed him still in prison. Old Lucky George, he's rich and living high. Poor old Tom come off the worst. He broke his legs and died of thirst. God, that must have been an awful way to die. But there was winters at the ranches and them old-time country dances. Everybody there was sociable and gay. We used to lead 'em down the middle just to prance into the fiddle. Never thought of going home till break of day. Well, there ain't much chance for sleeping when these memories come a-creeping, and sometimes you think you hear old voices call. When you're far away and dragging to the home ranch with the wagon, and you finished shipping cattle in the fall. Bruce Cascadden.
And recited by Randy Reiman. Well, thank you so much for making the ride this week. I sure hope you can join us right here next week at the same time for another fascinating guest and more of that great music. Thanks again to the Spirit of the West support crew, Mark and Kathy McMillan. And if you are looking for tractor parts, any make, any year, have a look at Mark's page, bctractorparts.com. To subscribe to Canadian Cowboy Country Magazine, you can call 1-800-943-7336 or just see cowboycountrymagazine.com. Till next week, I'm Hugh McLennan. Hope to see you down the trail somewhere real soon.